the new chapter, The 18th Planet, The Green Movement's Role by Nani Palkhewala. In this story, your writer describes one article that has been published in the year 1994, in which it has mentioned that our Earth becomes ill. Ill, the chapter, the title has given here, The Ailing Planet. Ailing means ill and planet means our Earth planet. What is required nowadays to save our planet is the green movement role. We have to save our Earth. We have to save our planet because soon this will be going to take an end because of our own human responsibilities that we are just doing against our environment, against our planet. We degraded the fisheries, we degraded the forest land, we degraded the green land and the crop lands. So all these things we degraded. So because of that, our planet becomes ill. Because according to this article, it has clearly mentioned that our Earth is also a living organism that is required to save all the vital role like fisheries, like green land, crop land, forest land. They have to preserve so that this ecological balance has not to be disturbed and it will not take our Earth to an end. So if this Earth will take an end, it's clearly that we are going to be end. So for that purpose, we have to just take care of our Earth, and because of that, this chapter has evolved in the syllabus. Let's see this chapter, what it has been told. The following article was written by Nani Palkhewala and published in the Indian Express on 24th November 1994. So this story is not a very, this is not a story, a fictitious or any fable. This is a story based on the reality that happened. The cases against the environment registered that has to be published in the form of article, and it is just an awareness for the young generation. Young generation here, it is called in this story, the era of responsibility. The young generation that is going to take the responsibility to preserve this, to all the maintain the ecological balance and make our Earth a living and a healthy planet. The issues that he raised regarding the declining health of the Earth continue to have relevance. Now the story starts. One cannot recall any movement in world history which has gripped the imagination of the entire human race so completely and so rapidly as the Green Movement, which started nearly 25 years ago. Like the Green Movement, we have heard about the Chipko Revolution also, where the things has to be taken action to save the deforestation. In 1972, the world's first nationwide Green Party was founded in New Zealand. Since then, the movement has not looked back. After that, we have not taken any initiative to just preserve the healthy condition of the environment. And because of that lack of things, we are now, our Earth becomes ailing planet. We have shifted one hopes irrevocably from the mechanistic views to a holistic and ecological view. Holistic and ecological view is the overall views that we have to look around our planet and look around for the world. It is a shift in human perception as revolutionary as that introduced by Copernicus, who taught mankind in the 16th century that the Earth and the other planets revolved around the sun. So this has been developed and established what? This truth has been developed by Copernicus. And when it is in the 16th century, what it has discovered? It discovered that Earth and the other planet revolved around the sun. So this is the first time in the human history there is a growing worldwide consciousness that the Earth itself is a living organism. please take care here, pay attention that here according to this article it has mentioned earth kya hai. Earth is a living planet. Earth kya hai? Ek living planet hai, living organism jiski khud bhi vital organism hai, that is required to make it healthy. And it is an enormous being of which we are parts. It has its own metabolic needs and a vital process which needs to be respected and preserved. So we have to respect the organism, the ecological balance, and it is our responsibility to preserve it and make our earth what? A healthy planet. The earth's vital signs reveal a patient in declining health. According to the article, it has clearly mentioned. क्या mention किया हुआ है कि earth जो है वो एक patient बन चुका है और इसकी जो health condition है वो दिन पर दिन क्या हो रही है? Decline हो रही है. वो standard जो है वो नीचे गिरता जा रहा है. We have begun to realize our ethical obligation. Yes, it is our responsibility, human beings' responsibility कि हम अपने ethics को जाने, to be good stewards for the planet. हमें एक good step लेना चाहिए अपने planet के betterment health के लिए. And we are the responsible trustees of the legacy to future generation. Because what we preserve, आज हम जो preserve करेंगे, same thing हम अपने आने वाले generations को देंगे. जैसे कि आपके forefathers ने जो preserve किया है, we are getting. And what we are preserving, the same thing we are going to hand over to the next generation. So it is our responsibility to maintain this ecological balance and preserve this planet Earth. The concept of sustainable development. Sustainable development means what? Sustainable development का मतलब होता है कि हम अपने needs को fulfill करें बिना harm किए future generations के needs को. Let's see. Sustainable development was popularized in 1987 by the World Commission on Environment and Development. In its report, it is defined the idea as development, वैसी development that meets the need of the present. जो हमारे आज के प्रेजेंट नीड्स को पूरा करे लेकिन विदाउट कॉम्प्रोमाइजिंग द एबिलिटी ऑफ फ्यूचर जेनरेशंस टू मीट देयर नीड्स. तो सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट का मतलब ये होता है कि हमारे डेवलपमेंट के लिए जो भी चीजें रिक्वायर्ड हैं उनको हम फुलफिल करें बिना किसी हार्म के, बिना किसी डिस्ट्रक्शन के अपने फ्यूचर जेनरेशंस के नीड्स को. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड द सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट. इन द जू एट लुसाका, यहाँ पे एक एग्जाम्पल आपको दिया जा रहा है कि एक जाम्बिया में एक जू है लुसाका, जहाँ पे एक केज है पिंजरा, जहाँ पे एक नोटिस लिखी हुई है द वर्ल्ड मोस्ट डेंजरस एनिमल एंड हु इज दैट एनिमल इनसाइड. उस इनसाइड केज के अंदर सिर्फ एक मिरर है और जब आप अपने आप को वहां पे रिफ्लेक्ट देखते हुए इमेज को, तो ह्यूमन बींग इज द मोस्ट डेंजरस एनिमल इन दिस प्लैनेट. Thanks to the efforts of a number of agencies in different countries. तो ये जो different countries के जो agencies है, they are poking to the human generations that be aware, be awake to just do something good and betterment for the earth planet. So thanks for the effort of number of agencies, a new awareness has now dawned upon the most dangerous animal in the world, that is human being. He has realized the wisdom of shifting from a system based on domination to one based on the partnership. Scientists have cataloged about 1.4 million. How many million? 1.4 million species are there who are still not recognized. So the scientists explained it that 1.4 million living species with which mankind shares the earth. हमारा जो ये प्लैनेट है वो 1.4 मिलियन स्पीशीज को शेयर करता है जिसमें ह्यूमन बीइंग्स भी आते हैं, लेकिन वेरी वाइडली एज रिगार्ड्स द स्टिल अनकैटलॉग लिविंग स्पीशीज, बायोलॉजिस्ट रिकॉन दैट अबाउट 3 to 100 million अदर स्पीशीज स्टिल लैंग्विश अननेम्ड इन इग्नोमिनस डार्कनेस. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू द साइंटिस्ट ये ऐसा एस्टिमेट किया जा रहा है कि यहाँ पे 100 मिलियन, 1 to 300 मिलियन अभी भी ऐसे स्पेसीज हैं जिनको हमने रीनेम्ड नहीं किया है या रिकग्नाइज नहीं किया है, बट दे आर स्टिल प्रेजेंट ऑन दिस प्लैनेट अर्थ. ऑन द न्यूली अर्ली इंटरनेशनल कमीशन विच डीड इंटर एरिया विद द क्वेश्चन ऑफ इकोलॉजिकल एंड एनवायरमेंट वो द ब्रांड कमीशन. वॉट इज दैट ब्रांड कमीशन विच हैड अ डिस्टिंग्विश्ड Indian as one of its members. Who is this gentleman? He is Mr. L.K. Jha. The first brand report raised question, are we to leave our successor a source planet of advancing desert, impoverished landscapes and ailing environment? So, इस ब्रांड कमीशन ने क्या क्वेश्चन रेज किया गया कि क्या हम आने वाले अपने जनरेशन को ऐसा वर्ल्ड देने वाले, ऐसा प्लैनेट देने वाले हैं जो कि काफी ज्यादा बीमार है, जिसमें सिर्फ डेजर्ट्स हैं, जिसमें सिर्फ लैंडस्केप्स हैं और एलिंग एनवायरनमेंट है, जो एनवायरनमेंट है जो काफी खराब है। क्या हम ऐसे प्लैनेट अपने इस तरीके के प्लैनेट्स को अपने सक्सेसर्स, अपने बच्चे, अपने और अपने नेक्स्ट जनरेशन को देंगे? Mr. Lester R. Brown, in his thoughtful book, The Global Economic Prospect, points out that the Earth's principal biological systems are four. What are the four biological systems? Let me tell you. This is fisheries. That has already been destroyed. Another thing is that forest that we have already cut down and makes buildings. Another thing is that grassland that has also been deserted. Grassland and the fourth one is cropland. Due to the population explosion, we are overcropping the lands and the result is it just lost its fertility. So these are the four ecological balance that we have already destroyed and they form the foundation of the global economic system. In addition to supplying our food, these four systems provide virtually all the raw materials for industries except minerals and petroleum. तो ये जो four चीजें आप देख रहे हैं ecological balance में, वो human being के सारे needs को fulfill करती हैं except minerals. Minerals and petroleum को अगर आप छोड़ दें अपने daily necessary life में, तो ये चारों चीजें जो हैं वो आपकी life के लिए satisfactory and they are sufficient and they are providing all that things that is required. In large areas of the world, human claims on these systems are reaching an unsustainable level. A point where their productivity is being impaired, they when this happens, fisheries collapse. हमारे यहाँ पे fisheries collapse कर चुकी है, forest disappear हो चुके हैं, grassland जो है वो barren waste lands में convert हो चुके हैं और cropland they are deteriorating. So in the protein conscious and a protein hungry world, overfishing is a common everyday. In poor countries, local forests are being decimated in order to procure firewood for cooking. In some places, firewood has become so expensive that what goes under the pot, please focus here, what goes under the pot now costs more than what goes inside it. What does it mean? Firewood किसी किसी place पे इतने ज़्यादा expensive है, इतने costly है कि आपका जो firewood है वो ज़्यादा expensive हो जाता है in comparison कि आप उस खाने में क्या पका रहे हो, उसका cost क्या है. आपके खाने का cost अगर 10 है तो उस firewood का cost 100 है. So that is the main problem that we are not focusing on that. Since the tropical forest is in the world, Dr. Meyer, the powerhouse of the evolution, several species of life face extinction. हमारे यहाँ कितने species हैं जो extinct हो चुके हैं, जैसे कि dodo आप ले लो example में, white tiger जो कि endangered है, तो ऐसे बहुत सारी हमारे species हैं because of these population and pollution they disappear, they extinct. And numbers of species are there, they are in the endangered areas. So the thing is that we have to preserve it. It has been well said that forest precede mankind, desert follow. The world ancient patrimony of tropical forest is now eroding at the rate of 40 to 50 million acres a year. हमारे को जो ये patrimony में मिली है, हमें जो ये विरासत में मिली है ancient tropical forest, वो काफी फास्टली वो डिग्रेड हो रही है. एंड द ग्रोइंग इश्यूज ऑफ द डंग फॉर बर्निंग डिप्राइव्स द सॉइल ऑफ एन इम्पॉर्टेंट नेचुरल फर्टिलाइजर. द वर्ल्ड बैंक एस्टिमेट्स दैट 5-fold इंक्रीज इन द रेट ऑफ फॉरेस्ट प्लांटिंग इज नीडेड टू कॉप विद द एक्सपेक्टेड फ्यूल वुड डिमांड इन द ईयर 2000. एंड जेम्स सेड, द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड रिसोर्स इंस्टीट्यूशन सेड द अदर डे, we were saying that we are losing the forest at an acre a second, but the reality is that it is much closer to an acre and a half to a second. And according to the 48A constitution, article 48A in the constitution, it has mentioned, what it has mentioned in that constitution, that The state shall endeavor to protect and improve the environment and to safeguard the forest and wildlife of the country. So according to the article 48A constitution कैसा कहना है कि जो state होता है वो responsible होता है अपने environment के लिए, अपने forest और wildlife की country को save करने के लिए. But that causes endless anguish. क्यों ये हमारे को anguish है, क्यों हमें ये गुस्सा है? क्योंकि the fact is that laws are never respected nor enforced in India. How many of we is just honestly enforcing the laws in our life? That is really very difficult. And this is the main question arises here, that we have to be aware, we have to awake with the present situation that we are facing because of the degrading condition of the environment. We have to be awake in our inner soul so that we can do something for the environment. And the same thing is mentioned in that article. For instance, the constitution says that casteism, untouchability and bonded level shall be abolished. But they flourished shamelessly even after 40 years of the operation of the constitution. Now, I think in 2020 also many of the families are still having this concept of the casteism and the untouchability and all that things that has been removed from our constitution, from the laws many years ago. So, a recent report for our parliament, estimate committee has highlighted the near catastrophic depletion of India's forest. What is this disastrous depletion? The last 4 decades, India, according to a reliable data, is losing its forest at the rate of 3.7 million acres. This is the data, but in the reality, it is much higher than that. Large areas officially designated as forest land are already virtually treeless. There is no tree. आप वैली में चले जाओ, थोड़े से क्रैकर बस्ट कर दोगे तो पॉपुलेशन, जो पॉल्यूशन का रेट होता है वो काफी हाई हो जाता है. सो व्हाई बिकॉज ऑफ दिस? बिकॉज इट बिकम्स सारे ट्री, सारे फॉरेस्ट लैंड हमारे क्रॉप कर चुके हैं और वहां पे सिर्फ बिल्डिंग्स ही हैं. सो देयर इज नो सोर्स ऑफ एनी ऑक्सीजन एंड ऑल दैट मेक अवर एटमोस्फेयर प्योर एंड ऑल. द एक्चुअल लॉस ऑफ फॉरेस्ट इज एस्टिमेटेड टू बी अबाउट 8 times द रेट इंडिकेटेड बाय द गवर्नमेंट स्टैटिस्टिक्स. जो गवर्नमेंट ने दिया है उसे 8 times, maybe 10 times it is much higher than the report. A 3-year study using the satellites and aerial photography conducted by the United Nations warns that the environment has deteriorated so badly that it is critical in many of the 88 countries investigated. जहां तक कि सैटेलाइट्स और एरियल फोटोग्राफी की बात है, वहां से भी ये क्लियरली विजुअलाइज है कि ऐसे 88 कंट्रीज हैं जिन्हें इन्वेस्टिगेट किया गया है, जिनकी कंडीशन एनवायरनमेंट की काफी ज्यादा डिटोरिएटेड और काफी ज्यादा बैड है. देयर कैन बी नो डाउट दैट द ग्रोथ ऑफ द वर्ल्ड पॉपुलेशन इज वन ऑफ द स्ट्रॉन्गेस्ट फैक्टर डिस्टॉर्टिंग द फ्यूचर ऑफ ह्यूमन सोसाइटी. इट टुक मैनकाइंड मोर देन मिलियन ईयर्स टू रीच द फर्स्ट बिलियन. अर्लियर क्या होता था, 1 million लग जाते थे पॉपुलेशन को डबल होने में, लेकिन नाउअडेज एवरी ईच आवर इट जस्ट गेटिंग डबल्ड. The present world population is estimated at 5.7 billion. Every 4 days, the world population increases by 1 million. That's the data in 1994. In 2020, it is much higher. Fertility falls as income rise. Education is spread, health improves. Obviously, if fertility, agar hum population pe control kare, hamara income kya hoga? Wo rise karega. Education is spread honge, hamare health conditions achhe honge. Thus, the development is the best contraceptive. But development itself may not be possible if the present increase in the number continues. लेकिन जब population के rate बढ़ते जाएंगे तो how can we just get the develop? Still, India is a developing country. So we have to control. The rich get richer and the poor beget children, which condemns remains to remain poor. Why? Because their concept is that there more children, more hands for the earning. But they forget that more children are the less things for their nourishment. So the population of India is estimated to be 920 million today, more than the entire population of Africa and South America put together. No one familiar with the condition in India would doubt that the hope of people would die in their hungry hutment unless population control is given topmost priority. For the first time in the human history, we see a transcending concern. The survival not just of the people of the planet, we have begun to take a holistic view. अभी इस प्लैनेट पे हमें रहन सर्वाइव करने के लिए सिर्फ हमारी प्रेजेंस जरूरी नहीं है. वी हैव टू मेंटेन द होलिस्टिक व्यू ऑफ दिस अर्थ. वी हैव टू मेंटेन द इकोलॉजिकल बैलेंस ऑल्सो सो दैट अवर future will be safe and preserved. The emerging new world vision has ushered in the era of responsibility. So, यहाँ पे मैंने आपको बिगनिंग में भी बोला है कि हमारे यंग जनरेशन को क्या कहा गया है, एरा ऑफ रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी. एरा ऑफ रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी का मतलब होता है कि हम जो यंग जनरेशन है, वी हैव टू टेक द चांस, वी हैव टू टेक द स्टेप टू इम्प्रूव दिस कंडीशन ऑफ आवर अर्थ. इंडस्ट्री हैज मोस्ट क्रूशियल रोल टू प्ले इन दिस न्यू एरा ऑफ रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी. वाटर ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन वुड बी इफेक्टेड if more businessmen shared the views of the chairman of DuPont, Mr. Edgar S. Uhland, who 5 years ago declared himself to be the company's chief environmental officer. He said, our continued existence as a leading manufacturer requires that we excel in environmental performance. Of all the statements made by Margaret Thatcher during the years of the prime ministership, none has passed so decisively into the current joke coin of English uses as a palliciatious word. No generation has a free hold on this earth. All we have is a life tenancy with full of repairing needs. So what does he wanted to say here? कि हम जो भी generations हैं, हमें ऐसा कोई भी हमें power और कोई भी legacy नहीं है जिसको पूरी तरीके से खत्म deplete करने का हमें कोई right है. We have to preserve it. In the words Mr. Lester Brown, we have not inherited this earth from our forefathers. हमने इसे legacy की तरह अपने forefathers से नहीं लिया है. We have borrowed it from our children. हमने इसे उधार में लिया है अपने आने वाले generation से, जिन्हें हमें एक healthy planet वापस return करनी है. So in this story, in this chapter, the ailing planet, the green revolution movement, Danny Palkiwala ने आपको एक बहुत ही एविडेंस के साथ, प्रूफ के साथ ये आपको प्रूव कर दिया है कि वी हैव टू थिंक अबाउट द कंडीशन ऑफ द अर्थ, अवर हेल्थ कंडीशन ऑफ द अर्थ. अदरवाइज दिस अर्थ, दिस प्लैनेट विल सून बी डिप्लेटेड एंड आवर इंडिया इज जस्ट मेकिंग अहेड द स्टेप्स रिगार्डिंग दैट डिस्ट्रक्शन. सो वी आर द एरा ऑफ रेस्पॉन्सिबल एरा, वी आर द जेनरेशन, सो वी हैव द power to preserve our earth planet for the coming generation. So this is whole, the summary is there. So I hope this will just make you clear the concept of the ailing planet. Hope this chapter will be liked by you. Please like and subscribe to the channel for the most latest updates and the next chapters and the book. Thank you so much, dear students.